Today, the president said in his Rose Garden news conference that we have met the moment and we prevailed. He said this on a day when we crossed a sickening and stunning milestone, 80,000 deaths in the United States. You may recall early in the pandemic, there was an estimate that 80,000 of us would die in this country, but that wasn't projected to happen until early August. Today is May 11th. More than 80,000 are dead. And the president saying, speaking about the American people and assumably his administration as well, we prevailed. In other words, mission accomplished, or sure sounds like it. And sadly, we know how that went. We have met the moment and we prevailed, the president says. Prevailed, past tense, as in it's already happened, it's over. Prevailed, as in we won. Later, the president said he was talking about prevailing on testing, though he didn't say that at first. He also then later said we're making great strides toward total victory. At the same time, the president is saying we prevailed. He's unable to articulate clear guidance for this country about testing and contact tracing and all the other elements needed to move forward. He subverted his own administration's guidelines. 48 states are partially reopened or making plans to do so, and many of them do not meet his administration's guidelines. The president doesn't seem to be too worried about that anymore. Instead, his answers at a formal press briefing in the Rose Garden were at first misleading, then insulting. Then he left. The president once again repeated a line that became something of a sick joke a few weeks ago after he first said it on a visit to the CDC. Anyone who wants a test can get a test, he said way back then. Amazingly, he repeated that lie again today, and his own people had to correct him right in front of him. His testing czar, Admiral Brett Giroir, corrected the president. Anyone who needs a test can get one, the admiral said. Then the president ignored that correction and repeated his lie once again.
If people want to get tested, they get tested. But for the most part, they shouldn't want to get tested. There's no reason.
No reason. Keeping them honest, that's not true now, and it has never been true. And the president's statements about testing have been all over the place since this crisis began.
Well, we're testing everybody that we need to test.
Anybody that wants a test can get a test.
We took over an obsolete, broken testing system. There's not a lot of issues with testing.
The governors are supposed to do testing. We are lapping the world on testing.
We have so much testing. I don't think you need that kind of testing or that much testing.
The notion that everyone needs to be tested is just simply nonsensical.
We've done more testing than every other country combined. So in a way, by doing all of this testing, we make ourselves look bad.
I have always said testing is somewhat overrated.
Something can happen between a test where it's good and then something happens and all of a sudden. This is why the whole concept of tests aren't necessarily great.
But testing certainly is a very important function, and we have prevailed.
We have prevailed. The president was also asked questions today about White House staff who have tested positive. Two we know of to date, Katie Miller, the vice president's spokeswoman and wife of top Trump aide Stephen Miller, also a White House valet. The president clearly trying to downplay that news.
How can you ensure Americans that it's safe to go to their own workplaces when the most secure workplace in the country, the White House, cannot contain the spread of the coronavirus? It's infected some of your own staff.
Well, when you say some, so we have a person, and the person got something happened right after a test was done. Three other people met that person, came into relative contact, very little contact, and they're self-quarantining. That is not exactly not controlling it.
Well, he can try to downplay it, but in a new policy announced today, all White House staff are now being ordered to wear masks. In fact, you could see them on display at the Rose Garden event today. And while any American who wants a test can't get one, the White House sure seems to be relying on testing when it comes to their own employees. Now, of course, the president is downplaying these infections in the White House and the change in mask policy in the White House because it offers evidence that no workplace, not even the White House, is truly safe. It also points the need for adequate testing of employees to at least keep offices and businesses functioning. The most graceless moment of today's news conference, and that's saying a lot, happened at the very end, where a reporter from CBS tried to ask a reasonable question. The president not only shut her down, suggesting the Chinese-American reporter ask her question to China, he then refused her question from our reporter and shut down the news conference in kind of a huff.
You said many times that the U.S. is doing far better than any other country when it comes to testing.
Yes.
Why does that matter? Why is this a global competition to you if every day Americans are still losing their lives and we're still seeing more cases every day?
Well, they're losing their lives everywhere in the world. And maybe that's a question you should ask China. Don't ask me. Ask China that question, okay? When you ask them that question, you may get a very unusual answer. Yes, behind you, please.
Sir, why are you saying that to me specifically?
I'm telling you, I'm not saying it specifically to anybody. I'm saying it to anybody that would ask a nasty question like that.
That's not a nasty question.
Please go ahead.
Why does it matter?
Okay. Anybody else? Please go ahead in the back, please.
I have two questions.
No, it's okay.
But you pointed to me. I have two questions, Mr. President.
Next, please.
But you called on me.
I did, and you didn't respond, and now I'm calling on.
Sorry, I just
the young lady in the back, please.
I just wanted to let my colleague finish, okay. But can I ask you
ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Appreciate
but
it. Thank you very much.